All right, welcome back, guys. I'm so excited we get to start the show off with a very good friend of mine. He's hilarious. You guys have seen him on Conan, the wonderful, hilarious Ryan Hamilton, everybody.
I'm single. Hilarious. I'm trying things. I'm trying to be, I can try things. I went on a horse-drawn carriage ride with a... I really did it! I went on a... Nobody does that. You're right. Nobody does that. You don't know anyone who's ever done that. It's like for people who don't know. I went on a horse-drawn carriage ride. You shouldn't. Here's what happens. You think about it, you plan it, and then you sit down and you go, we shouldn't have done this. I don't know why. Why did we do this? It's just, I keep having, it just feels weird, you know? I have this thought over and over again, which is, we have a car. I don't know why we're doing this. I keep thinking, we have a car. We have a car. Clip-clop, we have a car. Kind of cold and weird. I feel bad for the horse. Don't you feel bad for these horses? They haul strangers around Manhattan their whole life. Where do these horses live? You're a horse in Manhattan? Where do you live? In my head, he's got a fourth floor stable walk up in Chinatown, and he's got to clump up the stairs and kicks the door open and goes, I got to get out of this city. I don't know. I can't take it anymore. I'm going back to Kentucky. Why do we think this notion of the past is so romantic? We do that, though, right? But like 100 years from now, we're going to be going, hey, sweetie, you want to take a Ford Focus around the park? Should we do that? Isn't that... That's exactly what we're doing. If someone from 1800 came to our time and saw that, they'd be going, why are you doing that? We've been trying to get rid of those for a long time. They stink and die. I was walking down the street with a friend of mine who happened to be out of work, and we saw one of these carriage rides, and I said to him, I feel sorry for the horse. Do you know what he came back with? Oh, I bet he's happy to just have a job. That's the point you're at in your life? You're jealous of the animals who are working? He's got an attitude like these horses are coming over here and stealing all our jobs. I tried speed dating. Is anybody giving that a go? Do I know you? Two people are like, yeah, we did that. You know the concept, right? You meet a lot of people in a short amount of time. Here's what's interesting about speed dating. If one rejection a week isn't enough for you, give this a whirl. Because 30 an hour is a real rush. It really... It feels like emotional whack-a-mole is what it feels like. It's just this assembly line of rejection that we've put together that, yeah, this is a great idea. I tried online dating, too. No one ever wants to admit that they did that, but everybody knows someone who met on the internet. There's always half the couple. You ask, how did you meet? We met on the internet, and it's usually the man who's like, would you just stop telling people that... It's the laundromat, remember? Why is it? Because if a man's on the internet, it's like, you've done everything you can do. A woman's like exploring her options. A man's like, I've depleted my options. I I was reading in a magazine. It said if you're not involved in one of these online dating services, you're just going to get left behind socially, you know. So I signed up, and it changed my life. I went from feeling pretty good about myself to feeling like a leper alone in a room typing. That's what I felt like. Just, oh, look, she likes the outdoors, too. I can't believe how many people like the outdoors online. It's just, there are... There are a lot of hypocrites at home typing about their love for the outdoors with carpal tunnel syndrome. Just, I love hiking. Are you there? Where are you? Some technology is amazing. You know, what do we do without a cell phone? It's great. I can communicate mobile, and it sucks all the grease right off my face. Have you ever noticed that? It's disgust. Don't act like you don't have this problem. This is a universal problem. People stare at me like, not me. Yeah, you. Every time I get off the phone, I'm like, is there Crisco in my ear? What do I do with... This is disgusting. I should clean it. Nobody ever cleans it. You do the same thing I do. You look at it, you go, that's awful. And then you just rub it on your pants. And then right back to your face. Yeah, I'm still here. I'm exfoliating. How are you? Yeah, I'm... I was thinking about getting LASIK surgery. I wear contacts, so I was watching some ads. I saw an ad, $150 per eye. Seems low. I'm not into bargain surgery. You know, I'm gonna go ahead and spend the extra cash for the laser in my eye. And $150 per eye. Who's not getting the whole package, really? Are you telling a lot of people are walking into the LASIK plate, walking out like Popeye, and yeah, I could only afford to fix one. Could you move over to my right a little bit, please? I'm waiting on a check to clear. Don't clap. Don't clap. I don't have time for your adulations. Is that a word? I may have made that up. It would be tough having vision in only one eye. My friends would mess with me. Hey, Ryan, you want to go check out a show? We're going down to the IMAX. No, I'm going to stay in. I got a sight in my rifle. And I got this new kaleidoscope I've really been wanting to check out. So I did that joke once, and a woman in the audience yelled out, I just had one eye done. She was for real. She had one eye surgically corrected for long. She kept the other eye for nearsighted vision. What kind of personal hell did you create for yourself? I'm driving. I'm reading again. I'm cooking. Flight simulator. Crossword puzzle. Frisbee. You guys have been a lot of fun. Good night, everybody. Thank you very much.
Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV, live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City.